The singularity is the theoretical day that artificial intelligence advances beyond human understanding and begins to change civilization in ways we can't conceive of. Many fear the singularity.
Want to try the gray?
Not Pindar Van Arman. He's doing his small part to make it happen by teaching robots to make art. He's writing code that nobody's seen before and thinks his machines are on the precipice of creative autonomy.
Here's a de Kooning, and this one, the style is like just as interesting.
Wow.
That
looks cool.
And here is Guernica. Mm-hmm. A little darker, but transfer get
yeah, that looks like human suffering on my face.
here's the painting that...
Pindar is a computer security contractor in Northern Virginia, but for the last 12 years, he's been making robot artists on the side. These portraits are made by sending the computer two images and running an algorithm called style transfer. It takes content and style from one and applies it to the other.
Here's you as Marilyn Monroe.
So it doesn't quite capture what Andy Warhol was doing though, right? Because like instead of just making my hair blonde, it gave me like Marilyn hair. So how would it have to progress to make it more in the style of Warhol?
Yeah, it doesn't really capture context right now. So style transfer does amazing things. And a lot of data scientists are trying to make this even better, including myself. We're trying to find a way to add the context to it. We just don't know how yet.
The hardware is pretty basic. The robots can be built for just a few $100s.
There's the AI working.
The special sauce is his software program, a decade in the making, called Cloud Painter. Like a human artist, Cloud Painter remembers its past work and can try to improve it, and its style evolved over time. And the robots can see what they're doing because they use cameras to watch their work in progress and make adjustments.
I want them to always watch what they're painting because that's when they make the really good decisions.
Do the robots ever create something that falls in the uncanny valley where it's kind of creepy?
I've been at exhibitions where a fellow artist has come and is like, I don't know whether to be really impressed with this or really disgusted with it. And so it's in the uncanny valley in that I am trying to replicate human creativity. Mm-hmm. And it does make some people uneasy.
Pindar can tell the robot to paint whoever walks in front of the robot's camera. Or he can program it to paint something based on what's trending in Google News. But that still essentially means Pindar is the artist, and the robot is his medium.
Can a robot be creative?
Yeah, I definitely can be creative, but it's like a question of like, what level of creativity? Like, I think my robots, when they make portraits, they make all the same creative decisions I make.
It's actually making decisions about what to do.
Yeah, I have some paintings that I don't make a single decision. All I do is turn the robot on and say, paint the next person that walks in front of the camera. So there is a way a robot can use an evolutionary approach to develop an algorithm. It can randomly select all these algorithms, paint a bunch of brush strokes randomly on 10 different canvases, throw them up for sale on eBay. Whichever one sells the highest, it tries to paint a little more like that.
Do you think your robot has started making more beautiful paintings over time?
If beauty is measured by how interesting it is, definitely much more beautiful. But aesthetically, the aesthetics are going in an unsure direction because if I just wanted to make a beautiful painting, I could use a printer and print it out and be perfect. And so I'm going away from that. I'm trying to get more interpretation, more serendipity.
Ken Goldberg is an artist and professor of engineering who runs a robotics lab at UC Berkeley. We showed him how Pindar's robots work.
Robots will do unexpected things all the time. The fact that it does something a little bit surprising doesn't mean that it's creative. It's saying it's the nature of most machines, that they'll do things you don't expect. As soon as you inject any kind of randomness into a program, you get behavior that you may not predict. And this is essential to a lot of the deep learning or AI methods that are out there now. Being able to show where this uncertainty is arising is very interesting conceptually. But I want to make a distinction between that and saying, well, the robot is now being creative.
I think when people see a great work of art, mm-hmm. one reason they relate to it is because you think, oh, this great artist had the same emotion as me. So how could a robot create that?
Yeah, I don't know. Obviously, a robot won't be able to make emotional artwork until it is emotional. But that doesn't mean that when we look at a piece of artwork, we can't get emotions from it. So, you know, every so often, my robot will paint a picture that looks like a sad person, and that might make me feel sad. The robot was obviously not sad when it made it, but it didn't stop me from having that emotional reaction.